Now, in the second part of the video, let us talk about writing data to a file. How to write data to a file? There are two methods to write data to a text file: write method, write function, and write lines function. Write function is used to write data to a file. Syntax is very easy. Write, and in the parentheses of this write function, the string to be written to the file. So whatever string, whatever text we have to write to a file, we need to put it within the parentheses of write function. Similarly, we have write lines function. Write lines function, it is used to write multiple lines contained in a list. So multiple lines can also be written using function write lines to a text file. Now, while writing to a text file, we have to write mode W. So there could be two modes to write to a text file: W mode for writing and A mode for appending. You can see in the first example. In the first example, we have opened a text file book.txt with mode A. A stands for append. In append mode, what will happen? Whatever we will write, the new text or the new data item will be added at the end of the previous written data in a text file. Means the previous data will remain, it will not be erased or it will not be overwritten by the new data. So that is why we have written A, means append mode. Then we have written fout.write welcome to the world of programmers. So in this way, this line will be added to the previous data. In the second example, the mode is W. F out is equal to open bracket book.txt comma W. W means write mode. Now here we have written F out.write. It is creative and innovative. Now this line will simply overwrite the previous data of the file book.txt. So this data will be written and previous data will be erased. Now here in the program, the user is supposed to enter the title and price of the book, and user has been asked to enter how many records he or she wants to enter, which is in n. So by implementing for loop, you can see the user has been asked to enter the title of the book, then enter price of the book, then title and price has been concatenated in a third variable record, and then we have written the record by executing fout.write record. And outside the for loop, we have closed the file reference fout. This is how we can write data, one data or multiple data, to a text file. Let's move on. Now, working with binary file. Students, what is binary file? A binary file is a file which is used to write non-textual data. For example, images, video file, audio file, or data contained in list, dictionary, array, tuple, etc. So binary file stores these data in the binary format or in terms of zeros and ones. In binary file, there is no delimiter for a line, unlike a text file. In a text file, what happens? Each and every line in a text file is delimited or terminated by a new line character or slash n. But it is not so in a binary file. To open a binary file, the mode we will be using is B, So we will add B also. One thing is very important with the binary file is the pickle module. You see, in order to write something to a binary file or read a binary file, we have to use different functions, unlike text file. So function to write in a binary file we use is dump function, and in order to read a binary file we have to use load function. So these two functions, dump function and load functions, reside in module pickle. So module pickle need to be imported. So here in the example you can see first line is import pickle, so that we can use these two functions. So import pickle, then we have data E in the form of dictionary, which contains key value pairs like Namita 25,000, Manya 30,000, Tanu 20,000. Then F1 is equal to open m.dat, wb. So we have opened the binary file m.dat in w mode, b for binary. Then we need to write it. So pickle.dump. So dump is associated with pickle. That is why it is important to refer to pickle. So pickle.dump. Now it takes two arguments. First argument is the data to be written, which is E here. And second argument is the file reference, F1. So E comma F1. So in this way, we have written the data to the binary file. Then we have closed this file, F1.close. So in this way, data can be written to a binary file. Now finally, let us read data from a binary file. So in order to read data from a binary file, we have to use which method? Load method. Now import pickle module we have imported, F1 is equal to open emp.dat comma rb. Here the mode is rb. R stands for read mode, b stands for binary file. Now let us read pickle.load F1. So in order to read, we have used method load. So load, it takes only one argument, which is the file reference. Here it is F1. And whatever data it will be reading from the binary file will be stored in a variable E. Here E actually is the list which contains all the data of the binary file. Then we have implemented for loop so that all the data can be read and displayed. So for x in E, then we have written print x. So it will be writing all the key values, I mean key of the dictionary E. Then F1 close. You can see the output Namita, Manya, Tanu. In this way, we can write data to a binary file or read a binary file using dump and load method. So that is all. I have explained all the important topics of data file handling. Now you need to watch this video attentively, learn something out of it, practice the examples. And if you have any query, any question, you can leave your question in the comment and I will be replying all your questions. So maybe I'll give you some notes also on the chapter. Thank you.